Next tonight, Noel Moss was returning from a friend's funeral when he heard the news that his mother had been diagnosed with a large brain tumour. His mum didn't seek help until it was nearly too late, and she was told that she had just 2 weeks left to live.
Well, now with the support of Fixers, the campaign that helps young people make a difference, Noel from Cheltenham is planning an advert to make sure that families can spot the symptoms when a loved one is too ill to act. He tells us his story.
By the time I got to the hospital, the whole of me just switched off. I didn't even know what was going on because I lost 3 days.
At the time, I was actually on a train coming back from a friend's funeral. And it just went straight through my mind of going, I've just buried a good friend of mine and now I'm going to do the same to my mum.
I can remember having my scan and I can remember the doctor coming to me, saying to me that you've got a brain tumour.
When I saw the picture, I was gobsmacked. I was amazed to see the size of it. It's amazing to see something so alien in your head, in your body, that's not meant to be there. Scary.
I can't believe it's 3 years in June that I've had my operation.
I know, it is mad, isn't it?
You know, to think how far I've come.
I'm Noel Moss, I'm 24 and I'm from Cheltenham. My mum Margaret had an operation to remove a brain tumour 3 years ago.
This is a brain scan, a CT brain scan, demonstrating the skull, the brain, and this abnormal area here, which is a tumour. Pressing into the brain, almost like a tennis ball, would be pushed into a jelly.
My Fixers project is to make people more aware of brain tumours.
The three principal symptoms are those of epilepsy or fits, headaches with particular characteristics of early morning associated to vomiting of prolonged period of time, and the development of a focal neurological deficit that can be weakness, numbness, tingling, deafness or visual impairment.
The support group Hammer Out and David Carroll, who had a brain tumour, helped me with my Fixers project. What do you think the three key messages are to get to youngsters about brain tumour?
Brain tumours are rare, not as rare perhaps as people say, but they are a rare condition, so not to get too panicked about it. The fact that as a young person, knowing their loved one very well, they are in a really good position to pick up if there anything is happening with their loved one that is unusual. And next, third thing is that if they notice that something unusual is happening with that loved one, to not let it go, just to keep on nagging your mum or your dad and say, something's not quite right here, I think you need to go and get it sorted.
What I would say is that also help them to understand some of the problems that patients, etc., have, and in that way they can help them.
Good morning, Hester's Way Resource Centre.
My mum's now better and she's working as a volunteer at the local resource centre.
When I was told I had 2 weeks to live, it was frightening, very frightening, to think that if I didn't call the doctor when I did, I may not be here today. I think his project's very good because it would get the youngsters, like teenagers, to actually understand that somebody can have a tumour and not know about it.
When I first saw my mum after her operation, I felt relief. It was as if I had my mum back again, and now she's just able to live day-to-day life as if she was never ill in the first place. My mum's experience has made me want to do more, so next year I'm cycling from Land's End to John O'Groats for charity.
Well, if you want to find out more about Noel and Margaret, all the issues raised in that report, then visit fixers.org.uk. That's fixers.org.uk.